Billion in reduction the first year. But of the 56 billion in the House, 40 billion of it is either defense cuts that are excessive or gimmicks of one type or another that will not permanently reduce federal spending of the budget. One example of the gimmicks is that they're taking 4 billion, which has been in an escrow fund for several years in the litigation about offshore receipts, and putting it into the budget. Well, that reduces the reported deficit by $4 billion. But right now, the Treasury is borrowing that money from the escrow fund, so it will have to go out into the public market and borrow the $4 billion we put into the budget. So there will not be one dime change of Treasury borrowing, which is precisely the problem in terms of the financial markets today. Another way of showing the contrast is to say, what if they actually cut in the House budget by way of domestic spending? I'd point out that the baseline for domestic spending in 1986, if we make no changes in discretionaries or entitlements, is $594 billion. The House budget exempts from one dime of cut nearly 60% of that entire baseline of non-defense spending. $360 billion worth of baseline spending, not one dime of cuts. All of the entitlements, for the most part, pension entitlements are exempted. All the means-tested programs are exempted, all the education programs, the social programs, a variety of others. Now, there's just no way you can get a real deficit reduction package.
Hi, good to see you.
Hi, how are you?
Well, good for a minute. Have we a minute or?
Sure, absolutely for a minute. Right. Bob's got to solve this problem for you, Mr. President.
Soviets have put down a proposal in February. It's inadequate. It's problems with verification.
Is that the main thing, the verification, or is it the difference in what they want to cut down to?
Well, there are two problems. One is the verification, but it's related to the main problem, which is the data. They table figures, and they're simply lying about how many people they have.
Oh.
So they table figures that are about 160,000 less than what we know they have. And then actually, they don't wish to have adequate verification because we'll discover that they have more than they're saying. So that's the problem. So we keep pushing them on it, but so far.
It's been going on 11 years, and we have not agreed to the name of the negotiations yet. We call it MDFR, Mutual Balanced Force Reduction, and they call it MFR, Mutual Force Reductions. They don't like the balance.
They don't like the word balance.
So after 11 years, we can't agree on the title.
That's reflecting what they have to do is for us to agree to a treaty which codifies their superiority. Of course, we're insisting on parity, and we'll just sit there and keep insisting on it until they can just keep sitting.
Wonder what would happen if you go to the back of the table and started in on it. Never mentioned it, but just you started saying that, but now. We won't agree to any clause that will allow you to count what we have. We're not going to do it.
All right, good to see you, sir.
Well, it's good to see you. Listen, I hope you don't mind. We just decided, since the weather is nice, to go out and sit around on the patio out here.
Okay, great.
I sure do. Nice to see you again.
Welcome back.
Thank you. It's nice to be back here.
Thank you.
Yes, hello there. Nice to see you.
And Mrs. De La Guardia.
Hello there. You've just been here.
Yes.
Yes. Taken here, and then you'll come in and join us for a pretty picture. Graduated from West Point.
That's our picture.
Just by a coincidence, I have just come back from Annapolis from shaking hands with 1,032 graduates of the Naval Academy today. And they presented me with a Navy bathrobe. And then they showed me what's inside the Navy bathrobe in big gold letters.
Beat Army.
Beat Army.
Yeah, I won't hold on to that message, sir.
All right. Well, there. Well, we're very happy about the relationship we've had in these last few years with the present government here. Looking forward to a continuation of that.
I hope they continue to prosper, sir.
All right. I think it will. Now, would you come in and join us? Table decided they better get involved.
Oh, that's
this whole program too. So.
It's very important. Very well.
Well, it's good to see you and have you here. Welcome. Right. All right. Well,
thank you, sir.
Omelet. You begin by stealing two eggs.
Was that on the card, sir?
That came from a Romanian. He was a director at Hollywood. That was his story. He told it about himself.
Ambassador of Romania.
How do you do?
Mr. President,
welcome.
Thank you, thank you.
And
my
Mrs.
wife, Yelena.
How do you do? Nice to see you.
Thank you. Interpreter.
I'm Mr. Zorinsky. I'd like to present to you my
credentials. I'll tell you, why don't we do this, you and I, over in front of the fireplace for pictures, and then we'll have you come in and join us. We have captured it.
Care să-l salute și în București.
Well, I would like that very much.
M-aș bucura.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
You don't have any blisters on your hand, do you?
No. No, my magic handshake takes care of it. 1,032 of them. Works very well. You ever know how to do it? Hold out your hand. You just put it all the way in there.
Oh, my hands are weak.
And it goes crushing your fingers for you.
President, the ambassador of China.
Yes. Well, welcome once again. I know you've been here before.
Yes.
Well, glad to meet you, Mr. President. It's nice to see you, and we're looking forward to the president's visit here.
Well, you and I
are going over and trying to get your picture. You can join us after we take one picture. Well, you wait, and then you come in just a second.
Yes.
First, have just one of us, and we can exchange our papers.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is my letter of presence and my remark.
Yes.
All right. Oh, you. Thank you.
Yeah, go ahead.
Can you watch some on YouTube?
Oh, wait.
There.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you.
Well,
you can watch.
Well, I say we're looking forward to this meeting in July.
Yes, thank you, President.
Yes, I have brought to you, Mr. President, one greeting from Chairman Deng Xiaoping, General Secretary Liao Bang, President Li Xianlian, and the Premier Zhang Zhuo.
Well, I remember them. Remember the great pleasure on our visit there. What a wonderful time we had. So, welcome.
Thank you.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Goodbye. Thank you.
It must have gotten hot standing out there in the sun, though, for over an hour.
It was getting a little warm, yeah.
Where the pivot is. Huh? They're coming at you from both sides.
Yeah.
Coming in.
Well, that made it getting through faster.
President, the Ambassador of Jordan.
Yes, Ambassador, welcome. Well, we're looking forward to next week's visit with your king. You and I shall go up in front of the fireplace here and have a photo taken. Change our papers here. All right. Well, there's it. All right. We're admiring of what the king is doing in this attempt of the peace prospects. As helpful as we can.
I'm sure we have a deep sense of justice.
Well, keep working and keep praying. All right. Well, thank you very much. Good to see you.
Before we do that.
sure if they will ever be.
I've got to step back for so many of them.
Appreciate your help.